नमस्ते, मैं सत्विनी खुराना, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, फैकल्टी फिजियोथेरेपी एंड डायग्नोस्टिक्स, JVN राजस्थान। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट असेसमेंट एंड प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ थेरापेटिक मैनेजमेंट ऑफ पुडेंडल नर्व पैल्सी। बिफोर गोइंग टू नर्व पैल्सी, लेट्स लुक अबाउट एनाटॉमिकल कोर्स ऑफ पुडेंडल नर्व। द पुडेंडल नर्व इज फॉर्म्ड फ्रॉम द सैक्रल प्लेक्सस, a nerve network of nerve fibers located on the posterior pelvic bowl. It arises from the ventral rami, that is anterior division of the spinal nerves S2, S3 and S4. After its formation, the pudendal nerve descends and passes between the piriformis and ischiococcygeus muscles. It leaves the pelvis through the lower part of the greater sciatic foramen. It then crosses the sacrospinous ligament close to its insertion to the ischial spine and then re-enters the pelvis through the lesser sciatic foramen. After re-entering the pelvis, it accompanies the internal pudendal artery and vein, coursing anterior superiorly through the pudendal canal, also known as Eclogue's canal, a structure formed by the fascia of the obturator internus muscle. Inside the pudendal canal, the nerve divides into branches, first giving off the inferior rectal nerve, then the perineal nerve, before continuing as the dorsal nerve of the penis or clitoris. There is a variation with the anatomical course between individuals, however its close association to the ischial spine is generally consistent. Perineal nerve innervates muscles of the perineum and pelvic floor and gives branches bulbospongiosus, ischiocavernosus, levator and eye muscles including iliococcygeus, pubococcygeus and puborectalis. Levator and eye muscle also receive innervation directly from the anterior ramus of S4 nerve root. Nerve also innervates the external urethral sphincter. Branch of pudendal nerve, the inferior rectal nerve, provides motor supply to the external anal sphincter. Therefore, the pudendal nerve provides the voluntary somatic control of fecal and urinary continence. A way to remember the continence function of the pudendal nerve is S2, S3, S4 give the bulk of the flow. Pudendal nerve supplies sensation to the external genitalia of both sexes and skin around the anus, anal canal and perineum through its branches. As inferior rectal branch innervates the perianal skin and lower third of the anal canal. Perineal nerve innervates the skin of the perineum, labia minora and majora or posterior scrotum. A dorsal nerve of the penis or clitoris innervates the skin of the penis and clitoris, thus responsible for the afferent component of penile and clitoral erection. Now, what is pudendal nerve palsy or numb genitals? Damage to the pudendal nerve can occur over time due to entrapment of nerve, similar to median nerve entrapment at the wrist, which is called carpal tunnel syndrome. Damage to the nerve can also occur suddenly as a result of surgery or trauma to the pelvic region. Prolonged bicycling, nerve is compressed between the ischium and a hard object. Falls, childbirth, or from fracture traction from the fracture table during deduction and fixation of a fractured femur. The pudendal nerve arises from S2, S3 and S4 and it carries sensation to the external genitals, lower rectum and perineum. The pudendal nerve re-enters the pelvis under the sacrotuberous ligament and gives three branches. The first branch, inferior rectal nerve, provides rectal tone and perianal sensation. The second branch, the perineal nerve, gives scrotal sensation. The third branch, the dorsal nerve of the penis and the clitoris, gives branches to the corpus cavernosum. Symptoms of pudendal nerve palsy include peroneal pelvic pain, aggravated by sitting and relieved with standing. Pain and absent when lying down or sitting on the toilet. The pain can come and go and can be a sharp, burning and shooting pain. The pain will usually progressively resolve on its own. Other symptoms are loss of sensation or numbness affecting the glans penis and scrotum in man and the perineum and labia in women. Difficulty with bladder and bowel function and sexual dysfunction. Treatment options are typically conservative as the condition is usually transient and will improve over time. Thus, treatment includes rest, physical therapy, stretches and exercises, anti-inflammatory medication, injections or nerve blocks, and a last resort is surgery. Prevention option for bicyclists consisting of changing the sitting position while riding the bicycle and changing the seat from a narrow seat to a wider seat. The incidence of pudendal nerve palsy following routine trauma and elective orthopedic surgery procedures ranges from 1.9% to 27.6%. Excessive or prolonged traction against the perineal post of a traction table leading to direct compression and localized ischemia to the nerve are suggestive mechanism of injury. Misuse of traction and inappropriate placement of the perineal post leading to crushing and stretching of the pudendal nerve are two main contributing factors leading to its post-operative palsy. Sequelae may be sensory, motor or mixed. In most cases, these injuries are transient and tend to resolve within several weeks or months. However, complete neurological recovery may be unpredictable and the effects of ongoing dysfunction potentially disastrous for the individual. In terms of preventative measures, magnitude and duration of traction time should be minimized. Traction should be limited to the critical operative steps only. Additionally, the perineal post should be placed between the genitalia and the contralateral leg. A well-padded large diameter perineal post should be used more than 10 cm. Adequate muscle relaxation during anesthesia is particularly important in young men who have strong muscles and thus require larger traction forces when compared to elderly patients. Orthopedic surgeons should be aware of the pathophysiology behind the development of this palsy and the measures that can be employed to reduce its occurrence. The procedures where a traction table is employed consenting for pudendal nerve palsy should be considered by the surgical team. Now, related to physical therapy, there are stretches and exercises which have provided reduced levels of pain for some people. There are different sources of pain for people since there are so many ligaments, muscles and nerves in that area. Sometimes women do pelvic floor exercises for compression after childbirth. However, there have been cases where the wrong stretches make the constant pain worse. Some people need to strengthen the muscles, others should stretch, while for some people it is purely neurological. There have been cases where doing stretches have helped bicyclists. Now, various ergonomic devices can also be used to allow an individual to sit while helping to take pressure off the nerve. With bicycles, the seat height and tilt can be adjusted to help alleviate compression. there are also bicycle seats designed to prevent foot and ulnar nerve compression. These seats usually have a narrow channel in the middle of them. For sitting on hard surfaces, a cushion or Cockles cushion can be used to take pressure off the nerves. Now, what is pudendal nerve block? As said above, pudendal nerve supplies the feeling for the lower pelvic floor and external genitalia. This nerve can be injured by trauma or can become entrapped or painful from a variety of conditions, including bicycle riding, childbirth, and other conditions that cause pelvic floor tension. Pain in this nerve can be quite distressing. It can be felt as pain in the pelvic floor, upper inner thigh, or external genitalia, including a condition called vulvodynia, which is pain on the outside of the vagina. A pudendal nerve block can help relieve pain in these areas. It can also serve as a valuable diagnostic tool to help determine the exact location of pain. Pain management doctor can evaluate symptoms and decide if this procedure may be right. Now the procedure. A pudendal nerve block is done as quick outpatient procedure, typically in an ambulatory surgery center using X-ray, otherwise known as fluoroscopy. Prior to the procedure, an IV will be started to provide light sedation during the procedure. Patient is positioned lying on stomach with blanket covering while the area just surrounding the area for the block is cleaned and aseptic solution. Physician will be identify the location of the pudendal nerve using fluoroscopy. Once anatomy is visualized, physician will inject a small amount of local anesthetic to numb the skin at the entry point. Once numb, physician will direct a small needle to the area of the pudendal nerve. Next, specialized testing is performed to identify the pudendal nerve. After confirming a good position, a small amount of dye is injected to ensure the medication will be in the correct location. Finally, a solution of local anesthetic alone or mixed with steroids is injected through this same needle. This procedure is done at each level that is painful. The procedure generally takes 10 to 15 minutes because the pudendal nerve controls sphincter muscle. This procedure cannot be done on both sides on the same day. Typically, the procedures are spaced out by 1 to 2 weeks, and to ensure full recovery of function from the local anesthetic before first injection. Now, how effective is pudendal nerve block? Pudendal nerve block can be over 85% effective in diagnosing pain coming from pudendal nerve. Almost half of patients do see at least some lasting benefit from a pudendal nerve block. If patient do not see lasting benefit, physician can discuss other procedures targeting this nerve that can be an option. Even if the procedure does not provide lasting pain relief, that still serve as valuable diagnostic information that it is helpful physician to help guide treatment. Now, what risks are involved with a pudendal nerve block? A medial branch block is a low-risk procedure. The injection site is away from the most major blood vessels and the structures of the spine. Risks include bleeding, infection, damage to the nerve or surrounding structures, allergic reactions to medications, lack of pain relief, and soreness after the procedure. There is also a risk of temporary numbness in leg following this procedure due to medications spreading to the shattered nerve. Now, what happened after a pudendal nerve block? Patient noticed some numbness on skin in the area of pudendal nerve on the side on which the procedure was performed. This is normal and temporary and generally lasting less than 24 hours. This will not affect the function of sphincter muscle. Do not drive or perform any vigorous activity for 12 to 24 hours after the procedure. Patient can return to normal activities the following day. Patient will be able to resume normal diet and medication. Physician will schedule follow-up appointments. थैंक यू।